Another viewer request from one of the 2.5% of my audience who is female, even though she said you won't thank me for this when she requested it. I still said I'd take a look back at Star Crystal, which is a 1986 American alien ripoff, science fiction movie, directed by Lance Lindsey. Usually, I'd go into the production and background of the film here, but there is almost no information about this movie online at all. Hell, the director made two movies in his entire career, this and 1988's Real Bullets. So going in, especially with the warnings I'd received from my viewer when she requested it, I didn't expect much. So did it manage to get over the very low bar I'd set for it? First things first, the posters and box art, most commonly used with this film, are a thing unto themselves. One uses the tagline, "It is the year 2035, scientists have discovered a new life form they're about to wish they hadn't," except the film is set in 2032, as per the opening text card, and at no point do any scientists realise they've discovered a new life form before it kills them off screen in the first 10 minutes. This poster clearly wasn't shifting enough VHS tapes though, so they changed the poster to this one, which features a sharp-toothed alien and people in cryo tubes. Yet none of these things exist in this film. The alien looks like a 3-day-old semolina that's been dropped on the floor, then covered in KY jelly. Obvious puppet tentacles and whatever the hell this slug-looking thing is in the end. This isn't much of a scary alien monster movie. The plot is part straight alien ripoff and part philosophical twist ending that comes out of nowhere and makes little to no sense, and kinda has to be seen to be believed. In the year 2032, a crew of scientists discover a rock buried on Mars and take it back to their ship. After scanning it, they decide it's just a rock and go for a smoke break or some such, at which point the rock breaks open and oozes out whatever this is meant to be, and a crystal. Then everybody dies off screen. The ship, I assume on autopilot, manages to dock with a space station, and then that station inexplicably blows up as 5 people escape on the prior ship that they're being tasked with repairing. It is then the movie turns into a straight up alien ripoff, with the alien very quickly and gruesomely offing the crew one by one, with the ship being all very small doors and tight tube corridors between each room. It's literally like the director and writer Lindsey saw that one scene in Alien, where Dallas crawls through an air vent carrying a flamethrower, whilst the alien stalks him in a trailer, then thought to himself, I think you could make this one scene like 40 minutes long and people would love it. Bonus being, it would cost almost nothing to film. And he isn't wrong. The first 2/3 of this film are fairly enjoyable. The miniature work for the space station and ships are well done and have a certain charm to them, even though it is fairly obvious they are miniatures. To the point you can see multiple Millennium Falcons from Star Wars incorporated into the space station model. The sets are clearly just flashing knobs and spray painted plywood, with the actors spending a whole lot of time just crawling through what I assume was the one tube set they had. We also get the most famous background unexplained flashing, vaguely sci-fi prop ever made making an appearance. It's appeared in such films as Star Trek II, at least 6 episodes of TNG and Voyager, plus over 100 other productions. Sadly, the company who owned it and rented it out have closed their doors, so its career is now over. It all adds up to giving the atmosphere and set design a low-budget 80s sci-fi charm. One anyone who grew up in that era will recognise instantly, like an old warm and well-worn coat. The acting and dialogue is suitably awful and over the top, the kind of awful that is entertaining to laugh at if nothing else. The kills are fairly cheap but gruesome enough, with plenty of slime, blood and obvious puppet tentacles being put to decent use. As far as 80s cheap straight-to-video alien ripoffs go, up to about the 50-minute mark, this is a fairly watchable and charming effort, and I thought to myself, I think she's being a bit harsh on this, I've seen way worse 80s sci-fi. Then we get down to the final two crew members, and the last 30 or 40 minutes are such a drag. We get a lot of sitting around looking sweaty as alarms blare and computer readouts flash on screen. Keep your eye out for the many misspelt words the computer spits out too, because that's literally all the excitement you are getting for the next 30 or so minutes. The male crew member crawls through the tube corridor several times, once with a literal flamethrower, just firing it at fresh air every so often, because they never get attacked by the alien, or pretty much anything even mildly exciting happens to them. Then the alien finds God. Yep, that's a twist ending. The alien reads the Bible via his crystal, which it turns out is a super advanced computer, decides it was wrong to murder all those people literally by ingesting them slowly and painfully, apologizes to the two remaining crew members. They all become friends, the end. What the actual fuck? There's no climactic showdown, just a literal non-ending with Daphne from Scooby-Doo singing an incredibly cheesy 80s song as the credits roll. It's a brave and somewhat baffling choice, and I can't stress enough how much of a chore the last 30 or 40 minutes or so is to get through. So that's Star Crystal. Was my viewer wrong? Do I thank her for recommending this one now I've seen it? Kind of, I guess, but also no. The first 50 minutes have enough charm and engaging things happening, but the last act is a massive drag, and that ending is just absolutely what the hell were they thinking? If I was you, I'd watch the first two thirds of this, then just turn it off. Man, that ending sucks. Like, comment and subscribe, because next week it is Trancers, which is a time travel cult classic. And the flashy prop makes an appearance again.